Well, all I've got to do is get you thinking differently. Because if you always do what you've always done, you'll always get what you've always got. So who is a business owner in the room? Who owns a business? Fantastic. And then see a show of hands, who works for somebody in the room? Who's an employee? Brilliant. And then who are the business owners that wish they were still employees? And see a show of hands? Some of you might be looking for time. Who wants to get more time back in their life? Who would like to get more that they're doing? More time? Fantastic. Okay, so the next area we're going to cover is around leadership and management. So my purpose today is really to help make sure that you are going to gain from this increase in sales and profits. Can I see who would be interested in increasing sales and profits? Can I see a show of hands? Fantastic. We're going to change. So we need to inspire you to change. And my vision for my business is about creating a catalyst for change, growth and abundance. And that's what my vision is for my business. What I like to say though is having a plan. You've got to have a plan from today. But just because you've got a plan written down, it doesn't mean that it's going to help you unless you have the courage to follow through. You know, if you were to build a building on the side of your building now, if you were to build an extension, you wouldn't just get the builder in and say, hey, yeah, put it up over there, make it kind of look the same colour, that'd be great. How big do you want it? Oh, you know, to the end of that tree line, that'd be great, you know. You wouldn't do that, would you? What you do is you get an architect. You get an architect, you design a plan. And from that plan, you would then implement the actions that would build the building. So if that is the case, why is it that most businesses I go into do not have like some kind of active planning tool that they're actually using on a regular weekly or monthly basis to make sure that they're building what is supposed to be being built? There's a tool called Smart Sheets. It's basically a spreadsheet in the clouds, and what it allows you to do, have multiple access to multiple people, and it's actually a project management tool. And what it allows you to do is put in times, dates, who, and actually you can go down task and you can go down multiple levels. So you can grandchild, great-grandchild, great-great-grandchild. It's a fantastic tool I found to use. Now, the reason I found it is one of my clients, about a £4 million turnover interiors company, they ran their entire business on it. You know, all the projects they did, they ran through that. So it's a fantastic project management piece of software, and that's the one I recommend using. And it's about £9 a month, so it's not really going to break the bank. And you can have, especially if you've got a team with multiple users. So we've got about 15 or 20 of these things set up now at Bonacieux, at Tony's client, where they've got the main one that we work on with the directors, and each head of business has now got one, and they are then using them with their teams. So it's a great way of being able to manage what's going on and feed that information in. Because half the thing in a bigger business, they don't see what's happening. It's like right hand and left hand are doing different things. So in order to implement the stuff we're going to talk about today, you've got to have the right mindset. Because we know with athletes do a lot of work on the physical, but is everyone aware that they also do work on the mental side as well? Can you imagine? You know, it's also in the game. It's how they choose to play between these 6 inches in their head. So some of the things I'm going to share with you now about the success mindset that will help you implement the very things that you come up with today. Now, I know we're taking some time to discuss these things now, but they're the things that are going to help you get what you want to have implemented. So the first thing I like to talk about is about what is your response. How do you choose to respond to things that happen in and around you? Because all leadership comes from this gap between stimulus and response. So do you hit it with the angel or the demon? You know, in your head, you've got, you know, two people in there already, plus you, so that's at least three. So we're pretty much all schizophrenic. Like, we've got at least three people in our head. We're listening to the angel or the demon. You know, are we talking ourselves up or are we talking ourselves down? So are we looking at it with a great attitude? Are we gracious? Are we responsible? Are we enthusiastic, accountable and teamwork? Which way are we tipping? Or is it to the bad attitude? Is there blame, antagonistic or defensive? You know, which way do you go? Because one will spiral you down and stop you performing, and one will spiral you up. If anybody plays golf, you'll all know exactly what I mean. Depending on the last few shots you played, depends on how you approach the next tee. You're either happy or you're sad. And you've got to reset and get ready to play the next hole. So what happens in your head, how you choose to respond, is going to make all the difference. So if you give 100% today, you'll get 100% out. If you give to this, you put ideas down, you get involved, you talk with the people on the table, you'll get something from it. If you don't, then you won't. So let's get rid of the I know and change it to, huh, that's interesting. What can I learn from this? What are the one or two, three little nuggets I can take, put in my treasure box from today and take away and use? The mind is like a parachute. It works best when it's open. And also, you'll have some light bulb moments, some eureka moments. When you've got them, make sure you write them down. And in fact, the best way to get them done is to share it as well. Share it with somebody else on the table, because then you actually go, oh, I've shared that, I better get on and do it. Especially if it's somebody you know. And also, we want to try and have some fun today as well. Now, I did do a 7-week stand-up comedy course once. It was probably the most terrifying thing I ever did. I stood in front of 150 people, and they paid £5 each to come, and I had to tell jokes for 10 minutes. Terribly scary. So today I might make the odd joke, try and support me, because it's ever so scary up here. Just titter and laugh if you think it sounds like it might even be a joke, and that'll be great. But let's have some fun, because if we're going to do business, we might as well do business that we enjoy. Can I ask you all to raise your hands as high as you can, please? Raise your hands as high as you can, fantastic. Now, if I said to you, stretch, think about it, what could you do to really get higher than that? I'm sure you could get higher than that. If you could get higher than that, and I was to give you 10 quid, who's going to get higher than that? Anyone could get higher than that? What else could you do? Somebody get higher? Who can get higher? Hey, we have a winner! Fantastic. Now, yeah. So with a bit of encouragement and a bit of extra performance, and I have to check, I'll give you a tenner at lunchtime. But, you know, with a bit of performance and with a bit of encouragement and with this incentive of a reward, you see how people can actually expand and grow and develop. Now, some of you are sitting there thinking, I'm not standing up. Everybody else isn't standing up. But once one person breaks the seal, then the rest of you make it feel easier to do it. And that happens within your teams as well. You need to coach people to be the ones who stand up and be leaders, because then other people will follow as well. Okay, leadership. So the first thing we look at is personal leadership, as in, how are you as a leader coming across to your team? How are you as a leader developing yourself? Because if you're not developing yourself, you aren't going to be able to lead at a high level. They say your business will grow to the level that the leader has learned. So the first area we're going to look at is time. Because the thing about time, you can't get any more time back. None of us have got a little blue box that can go backwards and forwards in time. The only thing we can do is we can make more money. We can't make more time. So what we choose to do with our time is incredibly important. There are the same 24 hours in the day for you and me and for Richard Branson, right? And somehow he's done something different with his 24 hours. So we've got to look at what we're doing within that 24 hours. Because actually there is no such thing as time management. It is self-management. It's what you're choosing to do, or choosing to let yourself be drawn into across to your team. So if you set motivating goals, you're more likely to be motivated.